Stop motion is where you take individual pictures of items as they move through a scene, and then when you put them together as a video, it gives them the impression of movement, of interacting, of acting. You know, so you're taking an inanimate object, moving it a slight little bit, and giving it the appearance of life. In my video, I decided to use Tonka trucks and army men. I had to, in order to do this, I had to build me a studio. So I took a folding table. I had some poles that clamped to the ceiling, put some lights on it, and built me my own little studio to do my stop animation. It was actually pretty interesting, you know, and quite fun. And tedious at the same time, moving each little truck eighth of an inch, taking a shot, moving it again, taking a shot, getting the army men in there to move around and changing out the army men so that it looked like they were doing different things, crawling, pointing, interacting. I used my iPad to create this. I downloaded an app that I purchased called Stop Motion. And this actually did all the real heavy work for me in a lot of ways. I had to, of course, set up the shot, move the items, and take the pictures. By clicking on the screen, it took one frame, the next frame. But what it did for me was allowed me to select a frame rate and then published the video. I didn't have to bring all the images separately into Adobe Premiere or anything like that, and make sure I had the timing right. You know, how many seconds does the image have to show? And when you're trying to do something like 10 frames per second, which is basically what I used, that would have been very tedious. Now I took well over 1,500 shots or frames to create my 6-minute video. And not all of the 6-minute video had stop motion in it. So it was time consuming, tedious, and took a lot of effort. But in the end, it was really fun. Now, so you've seen my setup, you've seen my video, I've told you about the app, but how do you use the app? So let's take a look at that. To use the stop motion iPad app, you first have to download it and install it. But once you have it installed, you will just click on the icon, of course, to open it. When it opens, it'll open to a screen like this. The plus sign is for starting a new project, and of course, it'll also have all your previous projects. So let's start a new project. When you start a new project, it turns on the main camera, of course, and if you have it set up, viewing already what you're looking at, your screen will look like this. The purple box here is for the next frame. Once you set up your next frame, of course you can take the picture by pressing the red button. One useful tool is the onion, and that's this slider over here. If you slide it down, when you move your items, you kind of get a blurred effect. This is an overlapping of frames. This allows you to see where it was in relationship to where you're moving it to. That way, when you're taking your pictures, you don't move something drastically an inch and it's going to lurch, jump. You know, you want it to be smooth and go right. So it kind of lets you determine the distance that you've moved it based on what it was, and you can make adjustments. It also helps if, like I've done, accidentally hit a vehicle and it rolls off a little bit or something, and so you have to readjust it back into the original position too. The farther you slide this down, of course, the more you'll see, the more blurred. So if I was to take the next picture, it would look like that. So here's one of my projects where I've got these army men around the truck. They're supposed to be moving as if they're taking a rest, changing out drivers. So as I go through it, frame by frame, they start to move. If I have a problem with an image, like you get your hand in it, you're a little fast on the shutter key, you're still moving a piece, and so your hand's in it, and I've done that, believe me, You can click on the image in the frame down here, whatever image, and then you can delete it. You can paste in, you can copy, you can select different ones, and you can even set them for hold if you need that particular image to hold for a length of time. You can insert by recapturing. If you click on the help button, then the help labels come up, and you can kind of get a better idea of what everything is. Of course, your onion I've talked about. You can crop, mask, you can point and move. You can adjust, you can zoom in by tapping on the main screen. If you want to see what it looks like so far, you can press the play button. You can add media, import images, record voiceover by using this button down here. You can set up your project settings. You can change your camera settings. You can even set it up so that it has works off of a timer if you want to do time-lapse images. To go back to the main page where you start a new project or previous projects, you'd click on the arrow over here. So if I click on this gear, I can set up some things. I can play the last 12 frames. I can play as a loop, so it continually goes through. I can play at half speed if I want. And I can adjust my frames. Predominantly, I chose to use 10 frames per second. There were, on occasion, like the Army men, I did use 5 frames per second. I wanted to slow it down a little bit. You can also make some adjustments up here. Clicking here adds this nice grid. The grid can be helpful when you're lining shots up, making sure things are moving the right direction, kind of going in line. You can change the camera settings. Front camera, back camera. It has a green screen. I didn't play with that. Although I was using green screen, I chose to remove my green screen in post-production in Adobe Premiere. I will play with that one day, though. And then it also allowed you to take HD. But it does warn you that by using HD, the high quality, it's going to fill up your iPad pretty quick with all the images. It's going to take up a lot of room. So make sure you have the room on your iPad to do it. The sound came in handy when I was when I set my camera or my iPad up for like an above shot or a shot where I couldn't keep my eye on the screen, and I used a Bluetooth keyboard to take the picture. So it would give me the sound of a picture being taken, so I'd know it took the picture. Auto white balance background, and then how it focuses. Those all can be adjusted. Now, if we click on the clacker here, we get this. These are things that you can add. You can add themes to your stop motion. Foregrounds. Well, I guess if you're going to use one of the look of binoculars, there you go. Fade in from black, fade out to black, different effects you can use, and then you can also use masks. So that's themes. If you click on outline, that allows you to fill in some information like the movie name, the title, cast, studio, credits, things like that if you're going to use all that. Once you've created your stop motion segment, you want to exit here, go to the main menu by using the arrow, and then of course you want to export it by pressing the export button, and then you have your choice. I used the Dropbox. I love the Dropbox. It's a great way of moving files from one computer to another, and it worked very well for me. The movie does produce as an MOV, so you have to make sure that whatever you're using can handle, for editing, can handle MOV, which Premiere was able to import the MOVs from the iPad perfectly fine.